Here we go. Day four.
Well, Test match cricket, what a rousing reception for the players as they entered the field. Standing ovation. Ground will be packed again.
Very attacking field, as you would expect with a brand new ball. And of course, still a very healthy lead of 139 runs. So attack as much as you possibly can. You need wickets. Three slips on the gully, as you'd expect, but a very interesting position that Hamid is fielding. He's almost in the line of a second gully, but much deeper. Well behind square on the offside. Of movement,
all out swing, perfect example there, immaculate seam position.
To be the end of Jimmy Anderson's 20th over. Starts with a maiden. Score stays 2-1, 5-2.
You see how he rocks up today, Jimmy Anderson. He seemed out of sorts yesterday. He was off the field for a little while. Great anticipation in the crowd, as I mentioned. Anderson threw 20 overs. It'll be Ollie Robinson from this Kirkstall Lane end. India trail by 139.
Well, you were noticing yesterday, Bumble, that the Robinson had dropped his pace a bit in the late evening. After a good night's sleep, he should be okay.
Do you know, I think that's quite straightforward with a young chap who comes into Test match cricket. He'll have to build his Test match fitness. Got to be supremely fit. It's tough bowling fast, I don't have to tell you. Got to be as fit as possible, that their second and third spells don't drop in pace.
Problems behind the bowler's arm again.
Well, it wouldn't be cricket if it wasn't first overs. Expect this, and you sit down when you're ready.
Oh. Still having problems behind the bowler's arm. Have a look at that bat edge there, Bombo. In our day, when the ball hit the edge of the bat, it was just one red tick. You can see the entire outprint of the ball on that edge to show you how thick those edges are.
There was a batsman who used to rub them off pronto. Just leave the red mark in the middle of the bat. They were there yesterday, definitely. So he must be superstitious that he doesn't clean his bat. I want them rubbed off. Might there be plenty of them.
Oh, that's a lot closer than you'd think. I think he was expecting it to swing away again.
Batsmen have been confident to leave on bounce. And you see that's really close to the off stump, but the ball is bouncing over the stumps, and we've seen that with LBWs. Comers, it's coming in, it will be full.
Yet another maiden, score stays 2-1-5 for two.
But two comfortable maidens for India. Good discipline in these first two overs, just refusing to play outside that off stump against this new ball. And a fabulous aerial view of the ground. And they're flocking in.
Seen this competition come into the ground yet. not quite getting it right yet, Jimmy Anderson. Again, too many balls being left. The other one coming, Bombu, at late in Docker.
We're into the third over this morning and nothing's happened. We've not got the red all right. We're thinking Anderson out, and then there's an inner coming. So far, I think he's struggling for rhythm. He's played about with the footholds, hasn't he? He's been kicking away at the footholds. Call it outside of his crease.
Just his length as well, Jimmy Anderson, not just his line. That's the nature that he's playing, but as we have seen on so many occasions, sometimes the line isn't quite right. But because it's full, batsmen are then dragged into playing shots at balls wide and full. Can afford to give away a four or two just to try and make sure that length is right. Three maidens in a row, 2-1, 5-2.
Yeah, the three maidens, but they're comfortable. And a real good situs for the Indian batsman. Far better day today. Quite warm, we saw long sleeve sweaters yesterday, anoraks in the crowd. It's much warmer, a lot of sunshine today.
You weren't on the town last night, were you, Bumble?
No, early to bed last night.
Thought you invited them.
No, thank you, no. They might just be coming in from last night. Hello, hello, hello. Some sights today, Saturday at Headingley, fancy dress.
I think this will go upstairs.
Yeah, mate, no shot. Definitely not high. TV umpire to director, we have a player review for LBW. Original decision is not out. It's a fair delivery. No shot offered. So we'll go straight to ball tracking when ready, please.
Not quite ready yet.
Okay, we've got pitching outside of impact, hitting the wickets. Go back to Richard on field. Richard, you need to reverse your decision. You're on screen.
Well, Richard Kettenborough has to reverse his decision. That just looked plump. The ball was swinging back. It was full. There was absolutely no chance of it going over the top. Badly misjudged.
Well, in real time, it looked plumb. That's the result. First strike in the morning for England. And Pujara goes for an excellent 91. 2-1, 5 for 3.
Jim Karahani, the new batsman for India, coming in at number 5. You would have been watching the movement of the ball from the dressing room. You have to be very careful of balls that are just outside the off stump. That's just bad judgment. You could see the ball coming in from early. The angle was bringing it in. It continued on the same path. And that's the sixth occasion now that Pujara has come in after being overnight not out and not scored. Pujara joining Chris Cairns on that number 6. Brand new day, have to start again. Has been brought into back pad.
No!
Just looking at the pace of Robinson there. First ball 81 miles an hour, then 80, the wicket ball 81, and then adrenaline 84 miles an hour. Keep it round about there.
Getting a wicket always helps. Stepped up 3 miles per hour after getting that wicket. Ah! Off the mark, I think. Seems as if it's pad. Leg buys. In middle order has not quite gotten the job done for India. Best score of just 6-1 in the second innings at Lord's. Six for three. Well, we thought it was over. It isn't. No ball from Ollie Robinson, so one ball still to go. Now it comes to an end, 2-1, 7-3.
So a wicket for Ollie Robinson. Now Jimmy Anderson can have a go at Rahane, the new batsman. 2-41, Robinson in 20 overs, 5 maidens.
Two runs added to the Indian total. One no ball, one leg by. Off the mark now.
From the slips, slightly wobbled seam. You know, umpires are so keen on bowlers entering that danger area, and the laws are quite specific that you and an official warning, and then a second and final warning. If you do it again, you're out of the attack. Batsmen can do what they want, run where they want. A couple of deliveries ago, it was Virat Kohli. He just ran straight down the pitch. It never gets a mention. The bowlers, they're on them like a flash.
No!
2-1, 9 for 3.
There you go. Danger area, that mat. But the ball, they're on, umpires are onto the bowlers, administering the laws of the game for encroaching onto that danger area. But you watch the number of times that batters up and down the pitch, running up and down the pitch.
I don't think you need me to tell you that that's always been a batsman's game, Bumby.
Well, it used to be 4 foot, the danger area. It was extended to 5. I'd go up further, I'd say 6. Or, in fact, don't bother. They don't bother with the batters. So don't bother with the bowlers. When I was umpire, I had a batsman. I told him, look, you've got to stop running on the pitch. He said, what happens if I keep running? I said, you've got to take your shoes off. I said, you take your shoes off. He said, what, running my socks? I said, yeah. I said, laws of the game. I take your shoes off. You could tell the players anything. They've not a clue about the laws of the game. Another lad who questioned an LBW if I turned out, and he asked me to, you know, these hairless, these Ventolin hairless, inhalers. He hands it to me. I said, well, I don't want it. I'm okay, I'm stood here, I'm not asthmatic. He said, no, it's me inhaler. I said, I can see what it is. He said, well, I want you to hold it. I said, I won't hold it. I'm not holding it. He said, well, I'll use it as a ball marker. I said, that's absolutely fine. If it hits it, it's 5. I'm in charge.
No, 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 no.
They must be glad that you're now in the commentary box, Bumble.
I used to love it. You tell them anything. Straight drive. Don't worry too much about that. The England team in full of length, making play. It's a good shot.
No!
224 for three.
Six overs bowled, one wicket for England. Pujara without adding to his overnight score again. This is the man they want. It's been noticeable in this innings, Kohli has been leaving the ball a lot more. That he's been fishing at outside the off stump. Look at that stat there. This innings 45% leaves for that in this series, down at 28%. So, as he said before the game, you've got to put your ego away in England and let the bowlers come to you. Oh, leave that one exactly the same as the first innings dismissal. Kohli just didn't nick it.
That's a good ball, that angled in and left Virat Kohli. Watch this, and see that was angled in and just left him. Excellent bowling. It's a great battle, this, between Kohli and Anderson.
Apart from the outside edge, it was identical. Same shot, same bowler, same batter. Crowd getting behind Anderson. No, I don't think so. They're asking. Height, two noises. Anderson not interested.
Joe is. The skipper is. He's trying to find someone to tell him, yeah, go upstairs. He's not going to, though. This is just such terrific viewing, this. Great bowler, great batsman. This one doesn't leave him. This one comes back in, just a fraction high. Crowd sensing the moment. This is the test match moment. We talk about little moments in the game. It's right here, right now.
Get in tight in the offside, England. Don't let Kohli off strike. They didn't review. They thought it was going over. Did it hit in line? Yes. Was it going over? Yes. Bounce here at Headingley all game.
Yeah, two balls to go of this over. Moen Elliott mid-off, on your bike, no single. Hamid at backward point is quite deep. Got to anticipate if Virat Kohli goes forward to block, get in on that one. Just seeing who's at mid-wicket there. You can see on the right of screen near the umpire. He's got to get in on the one. Sense the moment. It's a match awareness. Very important at this level, any cricket really, especially at the top level. Land it is there next to the umpire. Not great shades either.
Behind. Original decision is out. It's a fair delivery. Can I have a look at front on spin vision, please?
Yeah.
Okay, just rock that back, please. Looks like it is close to the bat, but he's also clipped his pad as well. Can we have a look at Ultra Edge, please? Okay, he's clipped his pad there. We've got clear daylight between bat and ball. Okay, just rock back, please, for me there, please, Mark. Yeah, okay, the spike is in clipping his pad. Clear daylight between bat and ball. Roll the ball through, please. Okay, we'll go back to Alex on field. Alex, we've got clear daylight between bat and ball. We have a spike where it's batters hit the pad. Reverse your decision,
wow,
please.
What a moment. DRS at its best there. Brilliant from Anderson to Coley. Big noise. Coley said, did I just flick my pad? And luckily, the smart cricketer that is Ajinkya Rahane at the other end said, yup, Virat, review it.
Let's have a look here. Just watch Virat Kohli.
Yeah!
Looks like he walks. He was quick to look around there, Virat Kohli, too.
Well, if you didn't like DRS, you'd like it this morning. Pujara given not out, was out. Kohli given out. He's walking there. You're right, he's turning. And then he thought, did I just flick my pad? And luckily, Ajinkya Rahane said, yeah, I agree. Didn't quite sound right.
Tell you what, it's interesting, the mindset there. I reckon you've got to know he hit the pad. I just wonder if he thought he hit the ball at the same time. And that why he wasn't sure. But as you say, Ajinkya Rahane, being the cool, calm, intelligent cricketer, said, hang on a minute. Let's just have a look at that. I'm not 100% sure you hit that. Let's go upstairs and have a look. Or it was a bit like, this is really important. Let's just go upstairs anyway.
I mean, often with Virat, let's be honest, Virat often uses one up. He'll say, you know, I'm the best player. But he was walking, and it took Rahane to say to him, hold on, Skip. Let's have a look at this. And they were right. What an over from Anderson.
You don't think he did it on purpose, did he? Virat just think, I think I'll walk off and then I'll delay it, then I'll just review. Just the sort of few mind games. Surely not.
No, but I guess it shows as well, Esau, you know you hit it. You know if you've hit it. Don't think you do sometimes. There's so much going on. The pad hits the bat. No, he wasn't sure. He definitely turned and was on his way.
A huge moment right there. You could just sense it, couldn't you? You could sense there was a terrific over from Anderson. You felt if he could knock him over this last ball, what an over it would have been. And he thought he had him.
That's a beautiful drive. It is a full half volley. Ajinkya Rahane has his second boundary.
Robertson's got the ball to move this morning, but he's just been a bit too wide. He bowled that good setup to Pujara, but most of the other stuff's just been a tad wide. Important to back up Anderson here when he can sense the moment. How many balls left? What do you got? Two left of this over. Got to keep Virat Kohli on strike and give Jimmy Anderson another one. He's got to keep going. Since it's the test match, this next little 15-20 minutes with Jimmy Anderson with his tail up.
No, no.
Right, one to go. Nothing different for Robinson. This is where you can go a little bit wider and fuller, just make sure it's a dot.
It's funny, isn't it? Usually you want to have a bowl at the new batter. In this situation, you say no singles, keep one of the world's greats on strike. We want to bowl at him. New ball, Anderson all over him. No singles here, no little clip ball down to fine leg either. Hold a line, as Shane Warne said. Channel. Bowl in a partnership.
No, no!
He does. It will be Anderson against Kohli again. 2-2-8 for three.
And what a terrific over that last one was from Jimmy Anderson. Excellent skill. To see England getting around too quite quickly, getting ready in position. Virat Kohli's already ready there. He's marked centre. He's just waiting for Jimmy Anderson to get back to his mark. This first ball, so important right now, this first ball. Don't let Kohli off strike. Get the first one at him, then the second, then the third.
Yeah, we did that stat about how well Kohli has left the ball this innings. He's not left Anderson well. Whether he's expecting the in-swinger from Anderson, and then he's surprised by the out-swinger or the wobble seam, but he's not left him well. Ah, that's what England will hate. They will hate that. Brilliant batting, smart batting from Kohli. Tip and run.
Great stuff from Virat Kohli. Just to get off strike that first ball. We're just talking about that first ball. Let it build up the pressure again. Jimmy Anderson just got it a fraction short, didn't he? He was trying to push him back to set him up, but he just got it a little bit short. Allowed an easy single. Annoying. It's amazing just looking how easy Ajinkya Rahane played that. It's amazing how bowlers, you just sense the battle and you lift your game. The ball seems to do a bit more when you're in that contest with someone that you've had a bit of wood on. As long as you're not trying any harder or anything like that, you're trying just as hard. But just that, the great players just have that extra little bit to raise their game, that extra level.
Better rhythm today. He had a difficult day yesterday. Had no rhythm. Either end, he had no rhythm. All those clips of Pujara's pads, very Anderson-like. But he's back.
It's amazing just looking how easy Ajinkya Rahane played that. It's amazing how bowlers, you just sense the battle and you lift your game. The ball seems to do a bit more when you're in that contest with someone that you've had a bit of wood on. As long as you're not trying any harder or anything like that, you're trying just as hard. But just that, the great players just have that extra little bit to raise their game, that extra level.
Better rhythm today. He had a difficult day yesterday. Had no rhythm. Either end, he had no rhythm. All those clips of Pujara's pads, very Anderson-like. But he's back. It's another beauty.
Well, when we watch these replays, and we're always saying, can he leave the ball? That's the first thing. Can he leave it? Should he have played at it? And you just watch when Jimmy Anderson bowls that ball and his wrist, it just looks like it's angling into the batsman. And that's what draws the right-hander to push at it. And then it just holds its line or just straightens a little bit and just nips away. That's what draws you into that shot.
He's become, I mean, he started a swing bowler. Swing bowler, and he's now a sort of swing and a seam bowler with that wobble seam.
No!
It's So he can shape the new ball and then he just scrambles the seam a little bit and he'll nip in or out. So he's got so many different things to his armory at the moment. He's got good rhythm as well. Excellent from Anderson, 229 for three. Let's but look back at that stunning over that nearly ended in the wicket. That was very similar to the first innings dismissal. Anderson was all over him at this stage, then the nip backer. Root didn't review, going over the top. Kohli lays a bat on one, leaves one. And then the last ball, Butler wasn't sure, was he? Butler went up late. As Rohit Sharma said this morning on interview, it is a quick scoring ground. Virat Kohli moves to 50. First 50 of the series. England have kept him quiet. He'll want to convert to a big 100.
And he does convert too, just 26 test 50s and 27 hundreds in 95 games. And that's why he's one of the best, if not the best in the world. He does convert, he goes on and makes big hundreds. Loves the fight, loves the battle. Wants to be in the contest. And I think that's why he's so frustrated so far in this series. He hasn't really had an impact with the bat. Hasn't been one of his more fluent innings, but it's typical Kohli, the fighter that he is. There he is, Rahane, his senior player with him, saying, come on, Skip, do it together, you and me.
Score of 42 first innings Lords up until today. Missed out on a single there.
Yeah, that was a very long single. These two haven't got the best history between the wickets. That's a terrific record.
There's those stats of conversions. And talk about shooting 26 to 27.
A best of 254, not out.
Channel that corridor, he's just unsure about. That was the other thing Rohit said on interview this morning. He just knows, you know, in England you're never in. Some parts of the world you get to 50 not out and you think, I'm in, put me in for bed and breakfast. In England at times you're never in, so you have to concentrate doubly hard. Punch down the ground, save your legs, that will go away for four.
Yeah, just a fraction full from Robinson. A couple of boundaries in this over from Virat Kohli and a play and miss. Just shows you how you have to switch off with one of those play and misses. Any time over here, as Nasser Hussain was talking about, one can have your name on it, but if you do get something that presents itself to hit the boundary, it's over pitched or width, and you have to put pressure back on the bowler and get it away to the boundary. And Virat's done it twice this over.
Out, yeah, edge gone. Perfect comeback after two boundaries in the over. Brilliant from Robinson. Kohli leaves it now, but it's too late.
Well, it was full. Just was that spot again. We already saw Virat Kohli playing this at one in the over. We saw him hit a couple of boundaries. This one just held its line and just bounced enough. Catch the edge, good catch from the skipper. It slipped. Pretty happy with that, Joe Root, too. The big one, his opposite number. Indian captain is gone. Virat Kohli for 55. And India are now 237 for 4.
Talent and the swagger that is Rishabh Pant comes in at number 6, average of 41. How's he going to play? He's been quiet as well in this series. He's played a couple of little cameos. They're going to need a lot more from their number 6. Here's why he's at the crease. Robinson, brilliant. Brilliant today, brilliant in his short test career so far. And that's the pick of his wickets. 50 and out for Kohli.
Said, I wonder how Rishabh Pant's going to play, Nas. He's only got one way. I don't think he's got it in him. I think the Indian, you know, team management and leaders with Ravi Shastri and Virat Kohli will just allow him to go out and play. But sometimes,
I'll rephrase it then. How would you want your coach? How would you want him to play in this situation?
Well, one of my pet hates is someone, if they get out to a bad shot and say, well, that's just the way I play. That's a cop out for me. I think you've got to play according to the situation. I'm all for giving people license and being aggressive, but there's a time and place for that. Right now, what India need and what does the team need me to do should be the question. Right now, they need Rishabh Pant to bat for a long time. Risk-free.
Well, his risk has been outside that off stump. He has fiddled outside that off stump. He's flirted. Oh, he's charging. He's on the charge.
Well, how much is it smart batting or is it reckless? It's a bit interesting to see that, whether he's trying to run at Jimmy Anderson to put him off his length or he's just going to play that way. Could be interesting cricket here. Wouldn't go too far away from the TV screen right now.
I think in the winter in India, when Anderson took the new ball in Ahmedabad, he scooped him for 6. He's down the pitch twice here. And he scampered through, he's off the mark.
Good watching this. The other thing I'll say, just to go back on the Robinson dismissal of Virat Kohli, it's not always the bowler that takes the wicket should get the credit. It's also the bowling in partnerships, because I think Jimmy Anderson bowled beautifully there. He was all over Virat Kohli as well. They bowled in partnership, and this time it was Robinson that got the benefit. But, you know, Jimmy Anderson can take a bit of credit for that too, Nas.
No!
something that will keep England going. You can see the noise. Not only have they got Kohli out, but they'll know a bowler at number eight, whether it be Shami or Bumrah, will have their pads on. That will keep you going in the field. Two wickets away from a bowler.
Now, this is Jimmy Anderson's sixth over of this spell from this morning. He's bowled from the then all day so far. I just wonder now, with the only Bumrah in next, Jadeja, then Bumrah, just to bowl an extended spell this morning. His rhythm seems to be a lot better today. He's bowling beautifully at the moment, creating chances. He looks threatening. Just wonder if he can bowl another two or three on the bounce here. He sends one more wicket and England aren't far away.
Definitely, if you get pant on strike, Anderson's next over, then over at his end, definitely one more at pant.
Gone.
Anderson has deserved that. He's been quite brilliant. This is excellent from England.
Well, we've just been talking about how well Jimmy Anderson has been bowling. He deserved this wicket. That angle in again and then just leaves the bats. And we talked about it a few overs ago, how he draws you into playing that angle in and just the feint of the edges. Nice one to Joss Butler. Jimmy Anderson says, yes, sir. Thank you very much. Joe Root with a smile, and why not? Got India on the ropes. Jinkar Rahane's gone for 10 and it's 239 for 5. And it's time for a drink.
400 wickets. Tests in England for Jimmy Anderson. The stats in his career are simply staggering. 400 at home. Just at home.
You kind of look at a graphic like that and you think, well, that's an unbelievable graphic for a career as
a whole.
All
the beef he got.
Yeah.
Now then, stand by your beds. First ball he faced with his side in trouble. Rishabh Pant came down the pitch to Jimmy Anderson. Facing up to Ollie Robinson. It's a good spell of bowling from Anderson and Robinson. They're putting in a shift. Down he comes again, flashing again. Where are you on this with Rishabh Pant, Michael Atherton?
By the situation, I mean, he is an aggressive player. He's never just going to block himself into a deep hole. He's always going to play his shots and score runs, but it's just that balance really between risk and reward in the situation that India find themselves in. Just be sensible. I think what's preying on his mind a bit is he's played some poor shots actually, not least of which in the first innings of this game. A defence, as he shows there, perfectly solid block. But in the first innings, to this bowler, Ollie Robinson, really wafted it with a wide ball, feathering a catch through to Joss Butler, and that's not the first poor shot that he's played in this series.
Changes that he's made, in other words, not getting crossed over with his left foot not coming behind him, means he can access the ball easily for that defensive shot. He's not fighting it like he might have done at the start of his career. It's just his mindset sometimes goes a little bit all over the place. One thing he will say about him, there's never a dull moment. pitched. Gone. England have six.
Part of the value that Craig Overton brings to the team is his slip catching. He's mainly a bowler, he bats a bit, but he's also got good hands at slip, and England have been short of those in recent times. He's in at third slip. More good bowling from Robinson, quite full, pushed across Rishabh Pant, who is feeling for the ball, and that is a straightforward catch but safely held by Craig Overton. What a morning for England and for Robinson. And India now are struggling because England are into the bowlers with Pant gone for one.
Well, the morning continues to get better for England and for Ollie Robinson. He has four, England have six. And they're now into the bowlers. Here comes Mohammed Shami. The fourth time in the series, Ollie Robinson has dismissed Rishabh Pant. Prod outside the off stump, safely taken by Overton. A fabulous hour and 5 minutes or so of cricket that England have had. Robinson, four wickets, searching for that fifer. Oh, he might have got him, has he? No, says umpire Kettleborough. Too high, perhaps.
Well, the inducker is working to good effect, but I think it was too high. Got Shami on the above the knee roll, near the flap of the pad.
I think it's Dawid Milan who was fielding at backward points, and he was shouting across at Joe Root saying it's too high, it's too high.
Slightly away.
Fine margins. Been mighty impressive, hasn't he, Robinson?
Yeah, hugely so. Since he's come into the side, actually. Very accurate, moves it a bit either way. Good point you made about Dawid Milan there at backward point, because the captain can utilise fielders in all different areas to give him a clue on a review. And the men square the wicket, and Milan was one of those, get the best view of height. This curious fielder for Jadeja, very fine leg slip, Burns it is. He's almost stood right next to Butler. I think, how's it going to get that fine? Normally, if they get one into that blind spot, sure, in the left-hander's ribcage or armpit, it's going to go a bit squarer than where Burns is. Root sees it differently.
Nicely done from Jadeja, and a push down the ground for four. flirting away outside off stump, into the gap off a thick edge. Oohs and ahs around Headingley.
Oohs and ahs might have been cheers had they had an orthodox gully. I reckon this is right on the line of where a gully would be. But Moeen Ali's saving one, really, just behind square, and Root's catches are all in the slip cordon.
Three slips and Burns leg slip, no gully. First one Jimmy might have got wrong. 247-46.
Well, Coley looked settled and secure eventually yesterday, and that was built really on his ability to leave the ball. This is the area that England have had success against him in this series. Yesterday he was very disciplined. Today, this morning, starting again, he was feeling for the ball, looking to put bat on ball in that channel, and in the end it brought his downfall.
I suppose the only thing you can say about that is when he came to the crease, the ball was older, and it might have swung a little bit earlier out of the hand, which means you can line it up a bit more. This morning it was the new ball, which looks to be swinging a little later and then nipping. And that's what draws you in. If you see it early, you can line it up. Excellent bowl. Oh, that's very straight. He was a long way across there, Mohammed Shami.
That's why I think Anderson wants to bowl that, what we call a wobble seam ball at Coley, virtually all the time. You rarely see him run up with the fingers next to each other on the seam looking to bowl a classical outswinger. He wants to have that angle coming in to encourage Coley to play. It's close, wasn't it, that?
Oh, yeah. You could see leg stump. It was a long way across. That's why I said that's very straight. That's very straight. And full and out. Robinson has five. Fantastic performance from him. You wait to see if they review. They do.
To the umpire, to director, we have a player review for LBW. Original decision is out. It's a fair delivery. So can we have a look at front on spin vision, please? Okay, it doesn't appear to be any bat involved. Rock that through. We've got clear daylight between bat and ball, so we can go to ball tracking when ready, please. Pitching. Impact in line, pitching outside off, missing the wickets. Go back to Richard on field.
So Robinson does not have five. England do not have Mohammed Shami. Robinson's in-swinger does go a long way late, but that I didn't pick that one coming.
Blimey, I'd have had a good bet on that being out. It's very similar to the one KL Rahul got yesterday, actually. That looks out. You'd say for any money, with the umpire's call being out on the field, that will be at least clipping. Robinson will have to wait for his fifth. Shami a chance of getting off his pair.
Now, this is the first LBW shout, which Joe Root did not review. Amichami a long way over, missing two. Series. I can't tell what's going to happen, but if they do, that's a real comeback from what was a pretty chastising experience at Lords on the final day.
Very bruising defeat there. I think that the time away worked for them, just needed that after consecutive test matches and a particularly hard one at Lords.
Nice shot. That won't slow down much because it's across the practice pitches.
And just enabled England to regroup, made a slight change, bringing Milan in, and that's worked. It looks a stronger top three now, you would say. Would have played, I think, had he been fit. But Overton has come in as a decent replacement. I guess they'll have to think about Sam Curran's role at number eight. Number eight, the fourth seamer, they'll have some thoughts over that.
.253 for 6. Cricket, the home supporters have had. Morning, England have had. Two down overnight, India six down. The big guns are all back in the pavilion. Anderson has done a sterling job from the Emerald stand end. Naeem Ali is going to replace him. There is some rough, but there's been some swing and seam. Would you have gone with spin or would you have gone with Overton?
I don't mind this. I think it's dry. There's a left-hander, Jadeja, on strike.
Long off, long on. An easy single. The fielder you would think would come in for Mohammed Shami. Mid-off is certainly coming up. We've still got long on. The man at cow corner.
Having said, I don't mind Moeen Ali bowling. I don't mind him bowling, but not with a long on for Jadeja.
What do you reckon of this field then? That is an absolute rip-up. Root has got the decision spot on. Entrusted Moeen Ali, and he has delivered second ball.
It's the curve here that does for Shami. It's a beautiful bit of bowling from Moeen Ali, but he curves it away, and that makes Shami just reach for it, and then there's a bit of drop and dip and some spin as well. Kind of delivery and wicket that off-spinners dream about, even if it is a tail-ender, Mohammed Shami. You just love to see it spinning back through the gate because you know you've beaten them in the air and then off the pitch as well. So Shami gone for 6, India 7 down.
Well, the bowlers keep on coming. It is Ishant Sharma now for India. Root made the change at the Emerald stand end after an excellent spell from James Anderson. Brought on the spin of Moeen Ali, and he produced a fantastic delivery to remove Mohammad Shami. Mike Latham was saying that drift has just drawn the shot. Reach out of Shami through the gate onto, well, middle and leg. Good bit of turn. Actually, forgive me, straight onto the top of off stump. Ishant is surrounded. Short leg, leg slip, slip.
Bravo.
India trailed by exactly 100 runs. And Sharma is away.
The drift really, and that forces Shami just to push at the ball, and that creates the gap. So you've got to try and beat him before the ball lands in the air, and then after it lands off the pitch as well.
Six for seven.
Just a shout out for the former England and Glamorgan opener today, Steve James, who is cycling 100 miles from Cardiff in memory of his daughter Beth, who passed away tragically last year, raising money for Crohn's and colitis. And it would have been his daughter's birthday today, and it's going to be an annual trip that he makes, raising money for Crohn's and colitis. So a shout out to Steve. Hope the bike ride goes well. He's going to have a sore backside in the morning.
Good on you, Sid. I hope it goes well. Well, they can't get the ball out of Ollie Robinson's hand. 25 overs, 6 maidens for 64. A bit of protection for Ollie Robinson on the boundary on the offside. Moeen Ali is 30 yards behind square. How does Jadeja play it here? I mean, you've got to try and keep fighting, that's the way India go. You take the singles if they're on offer. I mean, how do you farm the strike when you're 98 runs still behind?
I mean, it is a lost cause, isn't it? But you can never play like it's a lost cause. You have got to play with a real deep sense of belief, whatever the situation.
No!
You've got to say to yourself, well, OK, it's not been a good morning. They've whistled all our batsmen up, and they're not going to get me out. I'm going to go down. Have a long, long net. The conditions are good. Get yourself into nick. Also try and protect the tail enders that you think need protecting, but put that high price on your wicket as well. And there's two tests left in this series, and there's always something to be gained out in the middle.
here is. Yeah, fraction two.
Ishant Sharma walks, he's not going to review. That is an outstanding performance from a man that has made an instant impact as he's come into the Test arena.
Yeah, congratulations, Ollie Robinson. He's bowled an immaculate line this morning. And that fifth wicket just about sums up the way that he's bowled. Perfect line in the channel, just outside off stump, making the batsman play, little bit of movement, and a host of slips and a wicketkeeper waiting. Outstanding this morning, and 5 for 65 fully reflects the way that he's bowled. Ishant Sharma, the latest to go for two, 257 for eight.
Jasprit Bumrah is the next in line for India. It's been a bit of a procession today. Six wickets in the morning session. We've still got over half an hour to go before lunch. 25 overs and five balls, 5 for 65 with six maidens. Second five-wicket haul, just his fourth test. Survives it. I've got them already in the series. They've had everything. 257 for eight. Card. Viewers watching the cricket on Sky Sports main event, you're going to be leaving us very shortly for the football, Derby Forest. So if you want to continue to watch the cricket, and you're watching us currently on main event, you need to go to Sky Sports Cricket. This time into the left-handed Jadeja. Down the track, and he's smacking it high in the air. Anderson won't get there.
Jadeja wasn't quite there as well to the pitch of the ball, but it didn't matter. He came down with only one thing on his mind. You can see how far away he was from the ball, and he was beaten really by Moeen Ali, who dragged the length back, but the power, muscle, took that ball over the rope.
My miss, it's never went that far. Livingston six, was it?
You were on air for that, weren't you? Went over the Emerald Stand. This is a miss hit, really, but still a miss hit that went for six.
Right time over, one ball remaining.
He was worried for a moment.
Yes. Livingston wasn't, he knew it straight away. Bairstow comes up in front, just brought Brimmer up. You get that drift again.
Gotcha!
Ooh, that's a beauty. Brimmer survives 264-48.
Eight down, 264 for eight. India still trailing by 90. Wonderful spell of bowling from Ollie Robinson. Now Craig Overton, 1 for 35. Sunshine, I've seen some wickets this morning. Looked to be a batting day, sunshine in warm. Terrific from Robinson. And Anderson got it right too.
Yeah, he sure did. Robinson quite brilliant. Unique nature of this ground, really. There are periods where batting just dominates and it run rate is high, and then there's periods where the ball comes back and comes back hard. Six wickets today from nowhere, really. That's why cricket here at Headingley is so watchable.
It has been a superb pitch. Then the ball starts swinging, that's nothing to do with the pitch.
Yeah, spot on. Ground staff have prepared a belt for it. Spun as well. In some turn for Moeen Ali. Jadeja got one to spin past Hamid's bat. Batsmen like Root have batted well. Pujara, Rohit, Milan, Hamid, Burns. So they can bat on it. Seamers have enjoyed it.
Jadeja down the ground.
Yeah, he's doing the right thing. He'll try and get runs, try and get some kind of lead. England would love to have an over at Bumrah with Moeen Ali. Sure, Jadeja doesn't get on strike, although Jadeja, as we've seen, is going to go after Ali as well. That gives England a chance at the other end.
he's come from there.
Yeah, he came up from there because England, as I said, want an over of Moeen Ali at Bumrah, so they don't want Jadeja nicking the strike. So at this moment, Root's not that bothered about the boundary. Overton is for his figures. It's important they keep Bumrah on strike after this delivery.
The fielder's on the square at mid-on and mid-off. He's got to be sprightly. Stop the single. Himself to four more. Good for Jadeja, good for England. 276 for eight.
And a bat change for Jadeja. The first boundary, toe of the bat obviously cracked, didn't bother him. He got two boundaries after that.
Here, 12 men are on, one for England, two for India. Had a bat change, they've had a drink and a towel down. But Moeen Ali can have a go at Bumrah.
Who's at mid on there? Jimmy Anderson. I'd like to see Jimmy Anderson a bit tighter. You don't want Bumrah just leaning on one to Anderson. He's quite deep there.
And that's the end of that.
They worked so hard to get him on strike and he's just chipped it in the outfield. There is a man out at deep mid wicket. Luckily, he didn't get anywhere near the middle of the bat. This is the battle as well, though. Jadeja against Moeen Ali.
Oh, Bob Marr!
He's bopped him down the ground for six. It was a miss hit. Scouts are out for England. Deep long off, deep long on, deep mid wicket.
Come on, come on, come on.
Oh, he's turned a single. So he's left Bumrah with a potential three deliveries.
And having seen the way Bumrah played that first ball, you may have an in-out field. By that I mean men around the bat, silly point, short leg, leg gully. But also fielders hovering about three quarters of the way back. Maybe now Anderson pushed back a little bit if Bumrah's going to play the big shot. In-out field. Toss it up, no. Tail enders. Once it goes above the eye line, they pick their bat up slightly wider, tempting.
There's one more to negotiate for Jaspreet Bumrah. He wants a single.
Easy.
Very firmly sent back. 278 for eight.
Got it, wait.
wicket, have you?
Message for three slips. Oh, and gone. Craig Overton, an indifferent first over. He's back on it.
Yeah, that's some delivery, that. From round the wicket. Last recognised batsman as well. It's not a tail ender. Round the wicket. Angle in, nip away. Find the outside edge. That's an excellent delivery from an excellent bowling outfit. They have been quite brilliant today. Jadeja's gone for 30, England one wicket away.
So the two rabbits, real tail enders for India. England have been excellent. Just the vagaries of a cricket ground, if you like. It's bright sunshine, the lights are not on, the clouds are high, it's warm, and there's been movement in the air. Last man standing. Anderson 1 for 63, Robinson 5 for 65, Overton 2 for 47. Moeen Ali 1 for 40. This is a beauty.
Siraj is in, and England have a fly slip. Generally, Siraj backs away and shows you his stumps. Target those stumps.
Both Robinson and Overton are tall, hit the pitch. It's a real advantage at Test match level if the mid-80s. You've got accuracy. They've both got solid run-ups and delivery stride and actions. Saqib Mahmood waiting in the wings, he's just as good. Catch. And that'll do nicely for England. They square the series.
A Yorkie takes the catch, Johnny Bairstow at second slip, he goes off towards the Western Terrace, who all celebrate. What a performance that is from England. What a bowling performance. If you think of the bowlers they don't have here, to bowl India out for 78 in the first innings and then make them collapse from 215 for 2 to 278 all out, that is quite a brilliant performance from England.
But we didn't see that coming this morning. It was such a bright day, it's a warm day, it's a batting day. But England have been irresistible. Johnny Bairstow again, a Yorkie at Headingley. It's a fitting end. Safe mitts. Just nipped in with a three for Craig Overton. Three for 47.
Yeah, real complete bowling performance. Anderson so much better today. He had just one of those off days yesterday. He was brilliant. Robinson, since he's come into this England side, has been outstanding. England have found one, that is for certain. They have depth in their bowling and they picked well in their batting as well. Orthodox players at the top. And a high-class player in Joe Root, who scored yet another 100. Three on the bounce, six this year.
Well, that was some bowling performance. The accuracy and the movement. Terrific for the series. Two test matches left. Thank you.